I just want to go to Fremont, which I'm going to do in like 2 minutes, but I'm motivated to do all the shit I need to do. Okay, bye. You were my never-ending full-leaf dream. You held the keys to what was bittersweet. Now you're my past tense, intense company. All right, waiting for the bus. Gonna go to U Village by myself. And then, yeah, basically spend the whole day by myself. Yeah, I literally never do this ever, but I'm doing it. Also mad at me for seeing what was never there. I painted pictures with the words that you prepared. I was so overwhelmed by all you had done. And it's confusing cause you let me hold the gun. Okay, I have a lot of thoughts about work and my perspective on how I want to go about what I do next as it relates to my career and like the path that I want to go towards, but I'll talk about that later. I think what's on the top of my mind right now is, since I've been back for like a week now, I've been settling back into my old routine, which is good because I think I'm like doing the things that was working for me before, but at the same time I can't do the same things and expect change to happen. So I'm really trying to make an effort to think about the things that I was doing and what wasn't working and try to really change it for the better. But it's hard because I don't know, I'll be doing the same things and I'll be like, oh, this feels good, but then I'll go back into my old habits, which is so natural. But I'm really trying to make an effort to make the most out of my situation and have a better perspective and have a better attitude and just like have more energy to do the things that I want to do and like keep doing the things that actually give me energy, if that makes sense. But yeah, I just think it's so interesting, this concept that like people have seasons, and I think everything has seasons. And if I just like look back on my time in Seattle, I said this before, but I feel like there's been so many chapters of my life that I've lived, and I think that's totally normal in like your 20s or whatever. I just feel like I'm such a different person now than I was maybe like a couple months ago. And I think it's such a, like, I don't know, a refreshing feeling, an amazing feeling to know that like you're constantly changing. Like the things that make you happy one day might not be the things that make you happy one day, and the things that you might not have felt fulfilled by before, like, you feel fulfilled by now. And I just feel like I'm making so much progress, I'm growing so much. Yeah, I just feel like I'm really looking forward to all the changes that are happening. Okay, one random thought. I really have loved vlogging, and I'm so glad that I did it and tried it. And I really want to like try to talk about my therapy or try to focus on my thoughts with work and like life transitions and just like my time in Seattle, like what it's like to make friends, like document all these experiences. I don't know, it's just like so many random things, but I feel like I'm going through so many life changes right now, like finding a new place to live, trying to figure out what I want to do with my life. I mean, that's a constant struggle, but like specifically with work, now that I've been doing the same thing I've been doing for 5 years and it's like it hasn't been working, and just like changing my whole perspective. And I feel like since I turned 28, I feel like I've just had a whole new perspective on things. And it's probably because I took this 2-month trip and I happened to just come back right when I turned 28. It's not like because I turned a new year or whatever. And yeah, it's probably related to the fact that Alex and I aren't together anymore, and just me thinking about how I'm like over it but not over it, but I'm trying to look at things from a different perspective. And I feel like I'm like believing in myself more, and I feel like, yeah, I just have so many thoughts, and I just want to like talk about them all in an organized manner in my vlogs, because I love doing them and editing them and reflecting on the things I say and like think about the things that I'm thinking about. And I'm just rambling. I've been really enjoying this, and yeah, I don't know. I have one more random thought before I stop talking. Okay, just a quick like reflection of the last 3 months now at this point. I left mid-February, took 2.5 months entirely off of work. I got back, it was my birthday. It's been a week since then. I've had one weekend in Seattle now, and then yeah, today is Tuesday. So second week of work since being back. So when I left for my trip, initially I wanted to spend a few weeks just having fun, not worrying about anything. And then I knew I would have some chill time in Japan potentially, because I was going to be there for so long, and I knew that Katie and Quinn were still going to be working. So I was like, okay, I'm going to try to maybe do some reading, do some journaling, do some vlogging, reflecting, potentially look for a new team to join, because at that point I was just still really angry by the people that I was working with now on this team, and I was like, I can't deal with them. But then Japan came. The whole trip basically was like go, go, go the entire time. I really didn't relax for any time. I think maybe like there were a couple chiller days here and there, like relatively, but for the most part, like I was like, I want to do all these things because I'm visiting all these countries for the first time, and I'm just with people that I want to hang out with, and I didn't want to be alone doing my own thing in my own world. I mean, I did a little bit like I said, but I also tried to like look for a new team, and all this like anxiety came flooding back, because I was like, okay, none of these teams sound really interesting. I don't really want to do more software engineering. I don't want to think about onboarding onto a new team, learning a new stack, being in this environment where I need to like impress people again and always be like on. And so I messaged Roy and I was like, oh my god, Roy, I don't know what to do, like I'm just feeling bad. And then his advice was just to like literally leave it all alone, take a complete like break and worry about it when I got back. And that's exactly what I did, and I was so thankful that I ended up doing that. So for the remainder of the trip, I basically just spent time with all of my friends. I think there was only one day that I slept in, and that was when I went to Hawaii, and I didn't have like any set plans, and it was kind of rainy, so I was like, okay, I'm just gonna sleep in, not set an alarm. And that was like the best night's sleep I'd had in a really long time, especially after like Australia. I just felt like I didn't get any good sleep there because there were so many of us in like a room. But anyways, yeah, so I get back and it's my birthday, and of course I'm like, okay, I want to see all these people, like all my friends that I miss, and there's so many things I want to do and catch up with everyone. And also like at work, I'm like, okay, I have to be on my best behavior, and I have to like make a good, I don't know, effort to try to reconcile things with my manager, with my team, whatever. And I was also really, really motivated to like reach out to people, have conversations with people that would maybe like get me in the direction I want to be with my career, or what I want to do with my life as it relates to work, whatever. So obviously I was really tired and drained this whole past week. And then this weekend, again, like, it was supposed to be me relaxing, me kind of like going to a cafe, just like chilling, trying to figure out my life, get caught up on work, because I think it was a bit hard to readjust and go back to the same like level of productivity I was at before I left. That didn't happen, because knowing me, I'm like, okay, if someone asked me to play volleyball, I'm gonna be like, yeah. And like, also the weather is so nice. So yeah, now here's today, and I feel like I'm trying to come up with a new routine, trying to like prioritize my life in the way I want to prioritize it. Things are looking up. I feel like it's going to be a good summer. I don't know. Maybe this is bad.